An inquest into the firebombing of bus driver Manmeet Alisha has heard his killer knew he had problems, urging officers to lock him up because he wanted to hurt people. The coroner hearing, Anthony O'Donoghue, had suffered from delusions for years but had never been consistently treated.
Anthony Mark Edward O'Donoghue, an undiagnosed schizophrenic when he threw a Molotov cocktail at bus driver Manmeet Alisha in October 2016, but he showed dangerous warning signs 5 years earlier, turning up to a Brisbane police station with a hammer, box cutters and tyre lever. His psychiatrist telling the coroner O'Donoghue told police he needed to be locked up because he will hurt someone. The inquest hearing, his symptoms had been around for some years. This core delusion, persecution, it had never been consistently treated. His initial assessor, Dr. Mark Barnes, recommending O'Donoghue remain on an involuntary treatment order. But Dr. Barnes' advice wasn't passed on to the Metro South Health team, who discontinued Mr. O'Donoghue's treatment in August 2016. Just 2 months later, he firebombed Manmeet Alisha's bus.
Definitely someone has failed us.
Another safeguard the inquest is looking at is full security screens on buses. The inquest hearing that assaults on drivers had continued to go up during COVID, 711 assaults last year alone. But former manager of bus operations at Brisbane City Council, Matt Anderson, says fitting out 1,267 buses with Perspex security screens is not viable and would come at a significant cost. Many of the barriers that were proposed for implementation were Perspex screens. Perspex screens generate significant glare.
They say it's this and then they say that's that, but it comes down to the money, I think.
New urban buses purchased after July 1 will be fitted with Perspex screens. Shannon Marshall-McCormack, Nine News.